Everybody, it's great to see you again. On the last video, we flew 170 kilometers in tricky conditions. This time, I'm gonna take you on an out and return flight under puffy little clouds. Sounds like heaven, right? Okay, let's go.
Gracias. Vale. Bueno, despegue catastrófico. Right, so we're off. Really low, only 1800 meters. And it's really mellow. Well, not super mellow, but really, thermals are not super strong, but this time it's good. I'm leaving with a nice group, so at least I have some company this time. I'm 12 kilometers away from launch. We finally have some clouds forming, which is great. I honestly don't have a plan because I wanted to go to the north as much as I could and then come back because the wind is supposed to switch. But the group I'm with is going towards the east, and it's working. Finally climbed to 2600, so I think I'm gonna keep going with this group and then maybe turn around later on. I'll see. All right, so we find a nice thermal here, and well, a vulture just indicated the best course, so we're not gonna argue with an expert. And well, it's nice to fly with people, although I would have done something different. I would have just gone tailwind. We're flying sidewind, but well, it's not super strong, so it's okay. So I left the mountain and I came here to the flats, and I was a little bit low. But I was checking on this farm here that maybe you can see, and I found a magical thermal with a little help from my friends, the vultures. Thank you, buddy. Okay, so I'm at 1700. Cloud base looks really high, so I hope next time I see you up there. Right, so I managed to get to 3000, and I'm gonna try to go to 50k's. So I'm gonna head to those clouds in front of me, climb, and then head back. I'm on my own. I've already seen a few people fly back. Yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do. Check out that beautiful bird, vulture. Nice. We're climbing at 3.5 meters per second, and he just arrived to my thermal and he's gone. He's gonna show me a better thermal, or he's just gonna head out, do his thing. 2000 meters. I think if it's like the last thermal, we have 1000 meters to go, so I'm just gonna get comfy in here and be patient until I get to my cloud. 2400 meters, still going up nice and steady, slowing down, but still going up. I'm gonna check out this area and change turn direction because I haven't turned to the right much. Is that it, boys? Oh, they're climbing better over there. Yes, that's what we wanted to find. Thank you, boys and girls. Wish I could tell the difference between a male, I'm sorry, between a male and a female. Yes, 5 meter up. I'm sorry, little bird. Meters, 3,000 meters. Oh, that's so beautiful, puffy cloud. Oh, okay, don't get feisty. Yeah, that's what I imagine it could happen. I would climb straight under the cloud. It's completely normal and ideal. 66 kilometers from takeoff. I honestly don't know what to do because up here I have tailwind, so it's perfect for navigating. So I'm just gonna keep going and see if I ever get headwind up here, and then I'll turn around. Right, so I'm approaching the end of my cloud street and I'm at 77 kilometers from launch, and what I'm gonna do is I think I'm gonna get to the end a little bit further, and then I can come back and surf it back again. Oh, this is like in every pilot's dreams to surf under a cloud street, no turning, just climbing. Love this. 2800, climbing 3 meters per second. Now a little bit slower. Oh, it's nice to see some clouds after 2 days of not a single cloud. I've been flying for 4 hours and I still have 4 hours left. So I hope I can make it back on time before the land by time. That way I'll be back home early and I can have an early dinner, go to bed early, do everything early and not at 1 a.m. Yee-hee. All right, 80 kilometers. Okay, where are you, thermal? What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to the edge and maybe try to get to 85. Would be nice if I found a thermal. 84 kilometers. 84 and a half. Let's make this faster. Five, four, three, two, one, 85. Phew. Good thing I have this pilot in front of me and he's climbing, so I'm gonna head straight to him. Signing off for now. Next time I hope I'm at cloud base and at 60k an hour. Right, so I'm 63k from takeoff. I'm making slower progress than I'd like to, but well, fortunately I'm not alone. There's another glider with me behind me, so we can work thermals together. I'm gonna finish my protein bar. Delicious. Yeah, buddy, this is a nice climb. It has already given us 250 meters. We're approaching 3,000 again, so let's milk it. Think it's over. We have 46 kilometers left to arrive to takeoff. It's not super easy. Thinking about going to the ridge in front of me, but I'm not sure. So I found a thermal down there, pretty low, and I climbed 1400 meters on it. It's really weak, so it took us forever. And I'm 41 kilometers from takeoff. It's looking really, really tough to make it back. But I'm gonna do my best and hopefully I'll land back at home. Thank you. Well, I think we started our final glide, unless we find something. We're 27 k's away from launch. I'd like to get to those hills over there, maybe reach sort them, so I can glide as fast, as far as possible. Otherwise, I have that huge field over there where I can land safely. Yeah, the problem when you fly towards the west, you have the sun on your face, in your eyes, and it's really tiring. Well, let's see if I find something.
I think I've started my final glide. Really low, there's nothing going up. Well, there are plenty of fields to land, so that shouldn't be a problem. I chose these little hills instead, hoping for some lift. It has beeped here and there, but nothing consistent. Right, so I'm looking for a field to land. Two bulls there, I don't want to land there. So let's land with my buddy. Those rocks over there were not super convenient. Golazo.
Qué guay.
Uf, qué golazo. Hola, buenas tardes. That was fun. 18 k's from takeoff. We almost made it back, but that's okay. Well, that was a fun flight, even if I couldn't make it back to takeoff. There are some lessons from this flight, and the first one is that I should fly faster under the cloud street. I should leave the thermals earlier and go to the next one, especially when you have a cloud street and you have the thermals materialized under the clouds. I'm usually a very conservative pilot, and that's why I don't risk so much. Also, I enjoy thermaling so much, and sometimes I'm not in a hurry, but yeah, if you want to be efficient and fly far, you need to fly faster. I know I said it was a 3 video series, but actually there's a 4th day in which things didn't go according to plan. So on the next video, I'm going to share what happened and what I learned from it. Would you like to learn some flying tips? Well, check out the extended version of this and all of my videos on Patreon, in which I explain the decisions I make and I give you some flying tips. I'm gonna leave the link on the description so you can check it out. Well, thanks a lot for watching. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please share it with your friend. If you haven't subscribed, hit that subscribe button. And well, until the next video, have a good flight. Bye.